Hi, Mayor. I'm good. How are you?
Can you get a...
Look, no, I don't they think work she works here, technically. We're doing a TV show. And it was right there. And as soon as I'm done, which will take like 30 seconds, that's okay. Don't worry about it. I would be more than happy to get you stuff. I would be more than happy.
I did not see that coming.
I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. All right. And three.
Hi, hey, you. That was awkward, wasn't it? Welcome to BossComps. We're taping our show this week here at the department store in the Eastwood Mall.
I have to say, I haven't been here yet, so when I walked in, I mean, blown away. It's so
cool. So
beautiful.
It's so like old school, like they have a candy store in the middle where they roast the peanuts and almonds and stuff,
right.
Candy coat them and all that good stuff.
And they have a toy department, like right. A real toy department.
So a shoe department where they actually fit you for the shoes. And auditorium where they have live entertainment during the day.
Right, and we got to catch up with the owner, Jim Boskov. What a guy.
The best.
Like really,
the
unbelievably
best.
Kind. So we'll have so much right here from the Boskov's new store over here at the Eastwood Mall. But Mike, I cannot wait for people to hear about this this pinstripe guy.
Yeah, this maybe you've seen his art at the Biker Brew House in Austintown. It's up there, and you see it from far away, and it just looks like a painting. Then you get really close, and you realize everything is just a real fine line that he paints with. So we're going to see the technique and learn about Keith, the guy that does it.
And we have two friends that have partnered in a very interesting way to keep a tradition alive when it comes to downtown Warren. Ken Hyderis and Jeff Canzonetta have teamed up again, and we're going to take you through why those two gentlemen are able to work together thanks to somebody looking down from above.
Yeah, speaking of Ken, Rudy Rudiger was at the Sunrise Entertainment, Robbins Theater. He had a big event, and I got to pull him aside and ask him a few questions. Turns out his first name is not Rudy. If you didn't know that, then we'll find out what it is.
And I get to catch up with Mark Canzonetta, and this is cobbler season. We've done them, but now we're going to do them in a different way, vegan friendly.
Mm.
And the ingredients that he puts into this stuff, you'd never believe it.
Can't tell, huh?
And it tastes even better than like what they normally would be. I can't wait.
If you keep tabs on these things, you're realizing that interest rates are going up a little bit, and Kelly Warren and Lauren are going to talk about that.
And I get to catch up with John Miles from Steelite International to check in to see how our restaurant industry friends are doing. You know, supply chain, they, you know, cater to people all over the world and how they're able to keep up with it still during COVID.
Do we miss anything?
I don't think so. Oh, yeah, we did, of course. The Rust City Church.
Oh, when you start, meet the pastor and his wife.
When you start something, where does it come from?
Yeah, started his own church. Oh, and by the way, it's super successful too. So we're going to find out why and how it all happened.
Probably because they're wonderful people, but nonetheless, a great show happening on Sunday, valleyspotlight.com and 4 p.m. on the WBCB. Mike, it's nice to see you.
Nice to see you. We'll see you Sunday.